Hello, yes, it has been achieved. Let the trumpets blare, let the songs ring out, let the fireworks blast, and let a thunderous, rapturous applause rise up for Lawrence the Cathedral Licker. A good friend of Archaeo Soup Towers, you may recall we interviewed him not that long ago when he was in the midst of his challenge to attempt to lick every Anglican cathedral in these United Kingdoms. And he achieved that 2 days ago on the 5th of December. Now he had several sort of legs in this journey. The first one was achieved on the 15th of June, the deadline being the 16th of June, to lick every cathedral, every Anglican cathedral in England. And that was achieved with his home cathedral of York Minster, a beautiful building if ever there was one. And then from then on, he had until the 16th of December to achieve the goal of licking every other cathedral in Scotland, Northern Ireland and Wales. And I'm happy to say that 2 days ago his final licks were actually in North Wales, my home region, as it were. He licked Bangor and St Asaph Cathedral, which you may recall from earlier this year. I actually took some photos in me and Mrs Soup's sort of video of our holiday, as it were, or certainly the historical highlights. I could not be more pleased. He sent off a celebratory text and also announced it on his Facebook page that it is done. So well done, Lawrence. Very, very well done. Now, why are we getting so excited about this here at Archaeo Soup Towers? Well, quite simply, because what he has achieved is near unique. First of all, just the struggle that he's gone through to make this happen. Lawrence, despite what some have, some rather vicious people have said, for example, on newspaper reports which have covered his journey, Lawrence has been doing this while working. He hasn't been on benefits or anything stupid like that. And frankly, one of these news stories was only 2 lines long, and yet people couldn't read that, you know, he works. He's managed to do this for the majority of the time while living and working in London on a less than impressive wage. He's planned very carefully how he's going to get out to each cathedral, often by journeying in the dead of night, and in some instances even sleeping over in bus stations, essentially. So he's really poured passion into this endeavour. But more than this, this has been a near unique opportunity to compare and contrast ecclesiastical architecture from across the UK. A cathedral, if nothing else, is a wonderful record of everything from geology all the way through to the social history, local social history of an area. Writ large on a cathedral's walls are the very livelihoods, the blood, the sweat and the tears of the community around it. And Lawrence has given himself a wonderful opportunity and experience in observing all of these different traditions, not only a tradition of worshipping at a building, but also the building traditions, the way in which people reflected their communities in this monstrous building in the heart of towns and cities across the country. Now, this was highlighted, this was really brought home to me, as it were, when we took Lawrence to Carlisle Cathedral. There were a selection of silver cups in the museum there. Mrs. Soup and I drove him essentially from Newcastle to Carlisle along near enough the route of Hadrian's Wall, because it was just the quickest way of getting in there. And there were these silver cups, and they were made in the style, or rather formed in the style of certain cathedrals from across the country. And he was able to identify them. He said, well, that's Ely Cathedral, that's Exeter Cathedral. They weren't labelled. And actually, when we went to Exeter, again, during our holiday, actually, Mrs. Soup and I both went, yes, he was right, Exeter Cathedral, that was that silver cup. So in this way, he's built up a fairly intricate mental catalogue of these buildings. And I can't really think of many other people who will have had this opportunity. Certainly not such a unique experience of the buildings, and also such a driving energy to get oneself there. I dare say there are many archbishops who haven't seen every Anglican cathedral in the United Kingdom. So in this way, he's got a wonderful opportunity to compare and contrast communities, buildings and histories, and essentially discuss the state of our cathedrals today. So this isn't just about licking, and it certainly isn't about disrespecting the building. Lawrence is first and foremost a passionate historian. I first met him working actually together for the York Archaeological Trust in York, and he cares passionately about the past and about ancient languages. So this was not done lightly. This wasn't just a bet. The bet was an excuse to achieve something which really he wanted to do desperately. So what's next? Well, he's going to start writing a book. Last night I had a sneak preview of the prologue to the book, and it's very exciting. It dives straight in to a lick halfway through the event, and talking about the tension building up to the lick and whether or not someone might try and stop him from achieving his goal. So I look forward with much enthusiasm to the development of this book and to its publication. I will certainly let you guys know when it's out to purchase. And frankly, as I say, it's going to be wonderful to share that experience. He's achieved something brilliantly British, uniquely English and fairly eccentric. And also, frankly, if people can write a book about dragging a fridge around Ireland, if you haven't heard of that, Google it. I'm sure you'll find who and what I mean. Then he can certainly write a book about, yes, licking cathedrals, but also about cathedrals themselves. He also, incidentally, wants to divert some of the funds that he may well get from either some sort of sponsorship or actually from books towards the upkeep of these wonderful historical buildings. So actually, cathedrals may even benefit from his journey, especially if they have the foresight to sell his book in their shops. I mean, for example, I certainly know several cathedral shop managers who have a good enough sense of humour to at the very least have a read and see what they think, and I'm sure they'll find out that what he writes is beautiful. What he talks about when he goes to these cathedrals and how he experiences the building will really, I think, do nothing other than drum up a bit of good feeling towards him and also their cathedrals. So hopefully they'll be featured in bookshops up and down the country. Anyway, that's basically what I'm here to say. Well done, Lawrence. Well done on achieving your goal. And I and everyone else here at RKSU Towers, and also many of our friends and family, look forward to hearing what happens next and how this amazing achievement develops. What really, I suppose, how you make hay really out of this particular part of your life. So well done once again. If you want to know more about Lawrence's achievements, go to his blog. I'll put the link in the underbar just below. And also, feel free to like his Facebook page. It hasn't got nearly enough likes, in my humble opinion. So check out that link as well. If you're on Facebook, just click like, because he doesn't post randomness there and people don't spam you. He only posts new stories about how essentially his time has developed on this journey. And actually, he's also been offered lots of TV appearances. So, for example, German television, certainly Russell Howard's Good News at one point was interested. I'm sure he won't mind me mentioning that. And also, actually, he's even been interviewed by radio stations. I believe it was Columbia, a radio station in Columbia, wanted to know more about what he'd done. So it's all very exciting. So once again, well done. And now you guys go away, check out those links, and have a great day. Bye-bye.